You want to be an assassin in Cyberpunk 2077? Today I'm going to show you the assassin gameplay and an assassin build. Welcome back, ladies and gents. Ivan the German is back for you guys, and today I'm going to show you some assassin gameplay and assassin build. What is an assassin in Cyberpunk? What is the stealth gameplay? And how good is the stealth gameplay in Cyberpunk 2077? So being an assassin in Cyberpunk 2077 is most of the times own challenge. Almost every time you do not get a benefit out of being silent or almost deadly as possible. Yes, in Cyberpunk 2077 you have almost every time the option to be stealthy, sneaky or very deadly, but not every time. And it's not as good as in other games like Assassin's Creed or whatever. In Cyberpunk 2077, I am a little bit disappointed about the stealth gameplay and the assassination thing. Yes, you can be very, very deadly and very, very effective, but it's more a challenge to yourself. You have a lot of options what you can do, but it's more like, okay, I'm only choosing blades, I'm only choosing knives, silenced pistols, silenced sniper rifles or whatever, but it's more, as I said, a challenge to yourself. Most of the times I'm playing a blade-wielded assassin, but I also have a silenced revolver because it fits perfectly into a very strong, very effective and very nice assassin. But of course you can go, and that's, as I said, a challenge for yourself, for 100% sneaky. The enemies are not alerted, you are killing every enemy from behind, only stealth, or even non-lethal. You can be a non-lethal assassin, or you only want to kill the targets. It really depends on your playstyle. And another quick thing, if you want to be a better gamer, subscribe to the Inside Gaming channel. We want to improve your gameplay and that you can become a better gamer. You have some different opportunities to enter an area if you want to be a sneaky assassin or if you want to be an effective assassin. Check around, look around. There will be almost every time a way to enter an area in a sneaky and stealthy way. Some side missions and quests will have a different dialogue, but that's basically it. And I hope they will bring like an assassination DLC or whatever to get a little bit more into detail in that term, because Cyberpunk gives a lot of opportunities or chances, but it's not done yet. But I guess that's the biggest problem in the game, that it's not completely finished. Well, let's continue with the cyberware, skills and gear. So for the cyberware you don't need that much. Same as my very strong blade build, I like the nervous system stuff. The synaptic accelerator and Kerensikov are very strong. You don't need the heal yourself or you don't need armor, because as an assassin, which is intended to play a little bit stealth or do high damage and don't get spotted, and you're not going into a big gunfight or in a fight in general, that's why you don't need that much health and armor. Of course you can use your mantis blades if you want to, but it depends on, as I said, how you think or how you define an assassin is. Attack speed is nice to have. Also, dense marrow increases stamina cost of melee attacks by 10%. Sounds bad, but you do 7% more base damage, which is great. You are not doing that many strikes to kill someone. One strong attack and the enemy is dead. But also it depends how you play your assassin. I would say the double jump is very nice for the assassin build, because you can get on very good positions above the enemy, check the location, scan the location. I would invest those 45,000 into the double jump. It's very nice, your approach is completely different. For the operating system, I'm using the Zandevistan MK5, which is a legendary. You can use the Berserker, or if you want to hack a little bit as an assassin, you can do that also to deactivate cameras and all that stuff. I do not need that. If I want to deactivate cameras, I'm throwing knives or I'm using my silenced pistol. So the Zandevistan is perfect. It increases damage while it's active and increases crit chance. And the enemies take 70% more time to notice you with this mod. It's the Arisaka software, which is great for this build. So let's check the abilities and the skills. Of course, you're focusing whatever you like and how you would like to play your assassin. You can play in a sniper assassin, or you can play with handguns or whatever. But let's start with the stealth. So Crouching Tiger is very nice, because you are, if you play an assassin which is focused on stealth, your movement speed increases a lot, and I would recommend that, of course. Increases damage from headshots, firing outside of combat. It's important in my opinion. Even if you're playing with a pistol or whatever, you do 50% more damage. More crit chance when you're entering combat as an assassin depends on your approach. You can sprint into your enemies, 50% more crit chance. Boosts movement speed when entering a combat. Detection time, 40%. Very important, the ghost one, take this definitely to not get spotted that quickly. the leg up movement speed after a successful takedown. The takedown is this one. It's if you are jumping from a higher ground, you can take down an enemy. And that's great if you want to play like a real assassin, guys. This whole assassin gameplay or game style depends on how you define that, as I said. If you are a sniper assassin, you maybe do not need this one. Increases damage dealt by silenced weapons by 25 while sneaking. That's great because as an assassin you can do a sneaky approach and that's very nice. The dagger dealer, you can throw knives, and that's one thing I do not like in Cyberpunk. You are throwing your own knives. You don't get any throwing knives. You're throwing your knives which you can loot and which can be very expensive or good. And after you throw a knife away, it's gone. It doesn't matter if you hit your enemy or not, it's completely lost. So that's why you need a couple of throwing knives if you want to play with them. But the great thing is it's a really quiet version of how to deactivate some cameras or kill some enemies on a bigger distance, snipers for example. The clean work is you can pick up a body immediately after a takedown, depends on your playstyle. If you made a mistake and you are in a gunfight and your health drops below 50%, reduce all incoming damage by 50% for 10 seconds. That's very handy if you want to run away or heal yourself, or it's like, okay, right now you have to go into combat. The ninjutsu, crouch attacks from stealth with melee weapons deal 100% more damage. Very nice if you're an assassin with blades or with blunt weapons, it depends on your playstyle. You should definitely go with this one. With the assassin perk, you deal 15% more damage to human enemies. Almost every enemy in Cyberpunk is a human, and it's nice to have that. Cold Blood, I would definitely recommend, no matter what playstyle you are playing, go with the Cold Blood perk. Why? Because if you get spotted, or if you can take down some enemies, no matter if you're killing them or not lethal or whatever, you get the Cold Blood perk. And with the Cold Blood, you have several very important benefits, or very nice benefits. So it's like, okay, after you're defeating an enemy, you gain Cold Blood, which increases your movement speed by 2%. You can stack it up to 3 times. And with Unbreakable and with Coldest Blood, you get 2 additional points, additional stacks. With the Predator, you increase your attack speed by 30%. That's why you can get an overall 150% more attack speed, which is nice with melee weapons. Then you can reduce damage taken by 5%. It's nice to have. The Blood Brawl, as you can see, I'm a little bit more into melee weapons. Will to Survive increases all resistance by 5%. You can see you have a lot of survivability in this Cold Blood path. So if you're playing with handguns, maybe Icy Veins is something for you. And if you reach level 20 in your Cold Blood skill tree, you get Merciless, which is quite awesome. You see that the Cold Blood is a little bit more attack speed and movement speed stuff and a little bit more of resistance. If you're focused on handguns, you don't need all of them, of course. Speaking of which, let's go to the handguns. And I choose the headshot benefits because my assassin build is like, okay, I'm using knives, but I'm also using a silenced revolver. Why? We will check that later on. That's why it's important to watch the whole video. But let's start. Increases crit chance with pistols and revolver by 12%. Then I have increases crit chance with pistols and revolvers by 20%. Increases headshot damage multiplier with pistols and revolver by 30%. You can see a lot of crit and headshot. Removes the damage penalty from pistols and revolvers when shooting from a distance. That's very important, Wild West, because you are an assassin and you get with the double jump very nice locations and spots so you can shoot from a greater distance. And the long shot drop pop increases damage if you are far away than 5 meters by 25%. You can see it's a little bit a long range approach with your assassin and you do much more damage. But as you can see, the handgun skill tree is very good and very nice. You have a lot of stuff which you can choose, but you don't need it as an assassin. You are deadly because your sneaky attacks and coming from the stealth is increasing your damage on your crit chance and your crit damage so high that you are doing a lot and tons of damage. But with this build, it's very important to aim for the head if you're using a pistol. Blades. As I said, I'm a little bit blade focused assassin and you have a lot of stuff. I'm not going to take the bleed stuff because bleed damage is nice for boss fights, but bosses do not live that long. That's why I'm not going into dodging and bleeds and all that stuff because my enemies are dying way before the bleeding effect is going to be useful. So let's start. Armor increased while moving. That's a little bit to improve your survivability. If you as an assassin made a mistake, or if it's like, okay, I want to rush. You are a deadly assassin. You're just here to kill your target. Nothing else matters. Armor is great. It's a great option. dodging increased damage with blades by 50%. It's very easy to trigger that and you get 50% more damage. Combine that with the armor, great choice. Deathbolt. While wielding a blade, defeating an enemy restores 20% health and increases movement speed by 30%. Very, very handy. Movement speed is so great, you are so fast and you can run around and kill everything. While wielding a blade recovers health when applying bleeding, it's like a nice to have. My sword has a bleeding effect, so it's nice to have, but not necessary. Strong attacks with blades deal 50% more damage, one of the most important things, combined with the Judge, Jury, and Executioner, increases damage with blades by 100% against enemies with max health. With this, you can one-hit almost everything with your strong attacks. Check out my blade video to see how strong and great this build is if you maxed out or go for blades combined with Cold Blood and the Stealth skill tree. Increases damage with blades by 3% for every 1% of health the enemy is missing. It's nice to have, but almost every time your enemy is instantly dead. And increases crit chance by 20%. You need crit chance and you need crit damage. Increases attack speed with blades. It's nice if you do not only want to strong attack your enemy, or even your strong attacks can be a little bit faster. And unfortunate, I do not have Dragon Strike yet. I played I don't know how much and I'm not level 20 with blades. I don't know how this is happening, but yeah, Dragon Strike is very, very nice. If you're level 20 with your blades, go for the Dragon Strike. For body, the Pack Mule is good for every build because I'm using melee weapons, 20% more melee damage, and I have a little bit more health. Annihilation, entering combat, your movement speed increased by 20%. Do not forget to pick up that one. If you are not a sniper, that's great. That's nice. It's 20% movement speed for free. That's basically it. Let's check the gear. And for the gear, it's like with my blade video. I'm not min-maxing in terms of gear. I want a cool looking character. I try to make a different character compared to the last video. It's like, okay, I want to have a full black assassin, kinda futuristic looking style. But yeah, if you want to go for min-maxing, go for movement speed with your shoes, crit damage, like I have the Johnny shoes and all of that stuff. Crit chance, crit damage, that's great, but I would recommend go for a better looking. If you have any problems, of course you can switch your gear, but for me it was important to look a little bit cooler, or that the style fits to this video. But for the weapons, it's a bit more important, but also it depends on your playstyle. So I'll start with my weapons. I have the Overture, and the Overture Revolver, it's the name for a specific revolver. It's not this iconic weapon. The Overture Revolver have a very high one-shot damage, 330 damage with a high crit damage and high crit chance. I can roll for over 250,000 crit damage with headshots. That's very awesome. So if you're playing as an assassin which is silent, or you want to one-shot your opponents, go for Overture Revolver, and it's important that you are using a silencer. And I will show you that one. You can use different silencers and different sights. I don't even have modded my gun yet because it's not necessary. You can do it if you want to, but I'm changing my stuff so often. That's why I do not modded it, but mod your guns. They can improve a lot. So, as I said, I am a blade wielding character, and I tested out the Satori because I upgraded the Satori to a legendary version, and the Satori is one of the best katanas in the game because you have a 510% more crit damage buff on this blade combined with a 65% crit chance, and that's way better than my old, let's say, old katana with 202 DPS, which is bought from your coach. You can buy this katana if you have level 11 street credibility. I bought my first katana at level 13, and the best version, I guess, has around 2400 DPS, but it depends on your level. On level 50, you have 2400 DPS, but the Satori is great because you have 510% crit damage. That's huge, guys. That's very huge. And I'm going to make a video how you can get both of those katanas. Maybe you missed it. Maybe you missed the pickup of the Satori during the mission, and you can pick it up right after the mission. Maybe you noticed it. Oh, I missed it. And I'm going to make a video how you can get this legendary version of the Satori even after the heist mission. And I'm using a knife. I'm using a knife because I like to throw the knives. I know it's very wasted. Or you can use this knife for your assassin playstyle because you like knives. Those knives can be very handy because you have 6.6 attacks per second base, and that's a lot. You are very fast with those knives, and they can be very fun. very funny. As always, you can switch your approach and you can switch your gameplay, your game style completely. You can switch knives for the Ashura sniper, a smart sniper, or you can take the power sniper rifle. It depends on your playstyle completely. This is my version of how to be a very effective assassin. It's a stealth assassin, or you can even rush into the enemies and be fast as hell. So what is the overall gameplay as an assassin? As I said in the whole video, it depends on your playstyle. If you're a sniper, it maybe looks completely different compared to a knife only, blade only, or pistol only, silence pistol only version of an assassin. It really depends on what you want to do. I played the whole time on very high and I never had a problem with killing enemies, but it was a self-challenge to be as sneaky as possible, or as sneaky as Cyberpunk is allowing you to be. In my opinion, it's great to play an assassin because it takes a little bit more time, but that's the benefit. Enjoy your time in Cyberpunk 2077. In my opinion, this game can be much greater. We should give it a little bit more time and you should enjoy your time in Cyberpunk 2077. And if you like what you see, do not forget to like this video to show the world we Germans can at least something. And if it's your like, that would be great. I would appreciate it and see you in the next video.